Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be another anti-haul. So I was looking through my old videos and I was like, oh my gosh, I haven't done one of these in literally a year and a half. It's time for an updated version, especially since there's so much new makeup coming out. I feel like makeup comes out just as fast as babies are being born. Not even exaggerating. Like, I know you guys can relate and vouch for me because every single time I go online or on social media or on YouTube, there's like a new makeup product and I'm like, I can't even enjoy the makeup that I have sometimes in my collection because I feel sometimes always obligated to be purchasing new things, of course, because I want to review it for you guys here on my channel. But there are just some times where I'm like, oh my gosh, like I need to take a breather. I need to like not buy makeup for a while, but there's just always something coming out. And I mean, I'm a YouTuber, but I'm also a consumer as well. And I feel like it's very wasteful to purchase so much makeup all the time. So there are times where I go online and I'm like, that doesn't really interest me, or you know, so I wanted to share with you guys, especially now that it's the holidays, products that I'm just not going to be purchasing for one reason or another. And that doesn't mean that I don't like these brands. I love a lot of these brands, but in general, the makeup world needs to chill. They have to take it down like several notches because I can't keep up and I can't be the only one. So let me know what you guys think. Also, of course, let me know what you guys are going to be purchasing or not purchasing. I will leave Kimberly Clark's channel down below. She is the original creator of this amazing idea, which I love. Also, I was looking through some anti-hauls and I came across Nicole Renee. She does an eyeing and not buying series, which I think is really cool. So if you guys are interested in any more of these videos, she has quite a few. I guess it's like a series on her channel and I love it. So I will also leave her channel down below as well. So anyways, I hope you guys enjoy. Don't forget to grab a snack and let's jump into it. All right, so I have my handy dandy screenshots here on my phone. So let's start with the very first product. I kind of just went through this week on Trend Mood's page. Oh, and by the way, I will leave Trend Mood down below. That is how I keep up with all new makeup releases. I went through the products that are newest within the last month or so. First thing is this Jouer Funfetti collection. It's a $25 set that includes a highlighter, lip topper, and an ultra foil liquid shimmer eye topper. It looks gorgeous. I've tried a couple things from Jouer and I was actually really impressed with their products, even though they are more pricey obviously because they're high-end. But the reason I'm just kind of like about this is because it's like there's already so many lip toppers and highlighters, and it's just like, how many of these things are these brands going to keep coming out with? Like, not just Jouer, but in general, like I said, makeup brands need to just chill, relax for a little bit, and just like not launch so much, because it's like, who really is purchasing every new makeup release that's coming out? Like, realistically, an everyday person who's working, who is going to actually be purchasing all of this new makeup? Like, I know, like for me, I don't want to because it's like, it's too much. Also, I have a bunch of eyeshadow palettes here. The first one that I'm just like, about is this one from Zoeva. I think that's how you say it. Kind of reminds me a little bit of the Urban Decay Born to Run eyeshadow palette, which I love, and I feel like I already have a million and one colors like this in my collection, so it's like another eyeshadow palette. It's kind of like, I love eyeshadow palettes, and there are some where I look at them and I'm like, oh my gosh, like I want that. It looks really gorgeous. But there's just some colors that I already know that I have in my collection. But let me know if you guys have tried Zoeva eyeshadows. I would love to hear, because I don't really hear a lot of people talking about them, but I saw this and I thought immediately, Urban Decay Born to Run. Sticking with eyeshadow palettes, I have the Kat Von D Lolita palette. I guess this is this a part two? I know that she has a Lolita lip color, which I actually really like. I feel like I already have eyeshadows like this in my collection. It kind of reminds me of an e.l.f. palette that I have actually in my collection that's like $10. This retails for $39. And I've tried Kat Von D eyeshadows before and I wasn't super impressed. I actually had to return. I bought two palettes from her before and I had to return them because they just weren't blending properly. I wasn't impressed with them. So I don't know if maybe I got duds. This was a few years back. I haven't tried anything recently. I do appreciate the fact that these are kind of like purpley pink shades. It's not your traditional warm colors, which are so common. I'm pretty certain that I have colors like this in my collection already, so I'm gonna have to pass on that, especially for $39 for a small little palette like that. I'm just like, that's a lot of money. Next up, I have the James Charles and Morphe collab. I was getting so many questions about this in my Instagram DMs and recently in some of my videos. So for those of you who don't know, if you didn't watch my video, I will link it down below. It's like a super long to check it ready with me that I did a few months back, basically talking about my horrible experience with Morphe, and that is a reason why I'm not going to be supporting Morphe anymore. So long story short, when I purchased the Vault collection from Jaclyn Hill, I had so many issues with it. I didn't like the palette, so I decided to return it and get my money back because I just felt like it would have been a waste for the palettes to just sit here in my collection because I didn't like them and they didn't work for me. I wanted my money back. I would have shipped the palettes out and it wasn't a big deal, but basically their customer service is horrific. I've never dealt with a brand like Morphe before and it really turned me off, especially because I was a consumer of their products products for such a long time. I mean, I've raved about their products and their, some of their makeup brushes on my channel for forever. So it was really disappointing to see a brand that I love so much with great products that just is so crappy behind the scenes. So I don't like that, and I don't wanna keep promoting a brand like that, because you guys have told me, and I've seen other reviews from other people who have had horrible nightmare stories with Morphe. And of course, people who are constantly getting PR from Morphe or working with them, of course, you're not gonna have a horrible experience. But as a consumer, for me, it was just not good. And I know that a lot of people were calling me dramatic and saying that this is too much, like, you know, it's not that big of a deal. But to me, it is a big deal, because if I'm gonna be recommending products to you guys, then you're gonna be going out and spending your hard-earned money. It's because I believe in the product and I believe in the brand. You know what I'm saying? So Morphe is just a brand that, I'm not saying their products are bad, but customer service and stuff that happens behind closed doors is not good. So nothing against James Charles. The palette looks bomb. Not even kidding. It looks really good, but I just can't support a brand like that. Next up, Kylie Cosmetics. And I think this is a really hot topic too, because her lip kits are actually now at Ulta. So I get often asked a lot of questions on my Instagram about why I don't use more of her products on my channel. And the reason is just because the products that I did try from Kylie, I wasn't impressed with. Some people will call me a hater. Some people say that, whatever you want to call it. I honestly feel like her products are just so overhyped, and the quality to me is not worth all of the hype. Like, I feel like it's very comparable to ColourPop. I know that I've heard that her stuff is made in the same labs as ColourPop. I mean, there's all different sorts of rumors with that. I don't know about all that, but I feel like ColourPop is a really, really great alternative to Kylie Cosmetics for a quarter of the price. I do feel like her stuff is overpriced, overhyped, and it's just kind of like, every time I see her new collections, I'm not super impressed. There are some things that I kind of like thought about getting before, but I'm just like, there's better alternatives to that. So, okay, Too Faced, it looks like they have another collab. This is the Too Faced Pretty Rich collection, and I'm pretty sure this is in collab with, yeah, Jordan Woods. This looks gorgeous, but I feel like Too Faced has sometimes an overwhelming amount of collections. Don't get me wrong, I love Too Faced. Their face products are bomb, but when it comes to their collections, I'm always kind of like turned off by them, because they're just, sometimes they're, one, they remind me of kid makeup. Like, I know their Tutti Frutti collection, it was kind of like, they have a lot of unicorn stuff, and then this is kind of just like, it's not really like catching my eye. I feel like just in general, a lot of collections nowadays are just, they just are kiddish to me. Like, they just don't really spark anything in my mind whenever I see them. And for Too Faced, unfortunately, it is one of them. Glosses look really nice, so I will say that, but it's just like, do I really need more lip products in my collection? Like, honestly. Okay, we have another holiday set. This one is from KKW Beauty. This is her holiday 2018 collection. I've tried Kim Kardashian's line. I've tried her lip gloss. It's like the super nude one. I forget what it is. It's okay. Not really too impressed by it. And I actually did try her eyeshadows before. Her formula is actually really nice. I have her Mario collection, and it was good. It's a good palette. I like the colors in it, but it's like, I feel like a lot of her stuff is very, once again, dupable. And it's kind of just very classic. I mean, I know Kim's looks are always very classic, very beautiful and neutral, so that's why her makeup obviously will reflect the type of looks that she does. But I personally feel like I don't need any more eyeshadows or lip products or really anything in my collection, because I have a lot of the colors that she has. It's like, realistically, what other eyeshadow look am I really gonna be doing if I get this? Like, I know myself, I'm gonna do something neutral, and it's like something that I could have done with like my $10 eyeshadow palette. Let's keep it moving. So next up, we have some Dose of Color. So this is their Mickey Mouse collection. I don't know if it's just me. I guess this is kind of like an unpopular opinion, but I am not a huge Disney fanatic. There, I said it. I don't know why. I mean, there's a lot of Disney stuff that I do like, but just in general, it's not like something that I die for, that I would go out and buy this collection. So I do applaud them for being different though, because you guys know in the makeup world, it's like peach collections, unicorn collections. Those are like the two main things that are like super popular, and that's kind of like just oversaturated at this point. So I do like the fact that they are being different. I guess if you're like me and you're not really a Disney fanatic, stuff like this, it kind of just seems a little bit like blah. I mean, at least for me, looks really gorgeous, especially the nude lip colors. You guys know that I'm living for those, but with the eyeshadow palette, I 100% already have that. I feel like I have Anastasia shadows that are like that. So if you have a lot of Anastasia palettes or even palettes at the drugstore, I feel like you don't need that. Speaking of collections, MAC, I feel like I can never keep up with MAC. I haven't purchased MAC products in a long time. Like, I'll usually just purchase like backups of things like Fix Plus or a powder, maybe like something like that. But when it comes to their collections, I feel like they never interest me. And so I know Patrick Starr has collabed with MAC in the past, so nothing against Patrick Starr. His collections look really good. It's just really hard to keep up with. And it's like another reason I don't really love purchasing holiday limited edition collections is because if I'm talking about this, let's say I purchase a collection now, if I'm talking about this like 3 or 4 months from now, it's not available anymore. You guys can't go out and purchase it. Sometimes. I know sometimes they keep limited edition stuff, but in general, limited edition stuff, it's not my favorite to keep and talk about it to you guys, because if you guys can't go out and get it and I'm recommending it to you, it's kind of useless in my opinion. Like, it's very like, why are you even talking about it type of thing. So that's why I don't love buying collections, especially limited edition stuff. Oh, I almost forgot that the Too Faced collection, also from Jordan Woods, I screenshotted it separately, but it comes with an eyeshadow palette as well, which looks really pretty. The colors kind of, again, look just like, and I feel like I've seen something before with these shades, like BH Cosmetics. I know that they have so many different eyeshadows. All right, so next up we have Anastasia. So they have 2 liquid lipstick kits, 10 nude shades, $60 for each kit. So it's apparently a $200 value. They're full size, which I think is actually a pretty good deal. But the reason I'm not living for this is because Anastasia's liquid lip formula isn't my favorite. For me, at least the colors that I had, they were a little bit drying. Even her lipsticks, I felt like they were too matte, like to the point where if I apply the lip color too much, the lipstick would break. It's just like too much. And a lot of these shades, I'm just looking at ColourPop. Like, I feel like ColourPop has really awesome dupes for so many higher end liquid lipsticks. I don't really feel like Anastasia's liquid lip formula is that amazing to the point where I'm gonna be buying that many liquid lipsticks from them. Okay, so then I have the e.l.f. Glowing Jelly Formula Highlight. So, I've actually tried a few jelly highlights before and I just didn't like the formula of them. So I've just come to the conclusion that I'm not really obsessed with like liquid or jelly products on my face as much as I am with powder. Like, I love me a good powder highlight. Just give me that, give me some good setting spray to make it a little bit more intense, and I'm good to go. I like things to be simple, and I think, I mean, the jelly concept to me is kind of just like, I mean, the colors do look really pretty though, and I love e.l.f. so much. You guys know that, and it's so affordable. They're only $6 a piece, but it's just like, am I really gonna actually use that? No, it's not super convenient. Whereas if I just get a brush and a powder highlight, it's just easier, it's better, and I think it looks better, honestly. We have some more collections to talk about. So this is their ColourPop's new Colorful with Iridescent Finish Holiday Collection. This kind of reminds me of Claire's makeup. Do you guys remember Claire's? Like, I used to beg my mom for makeup from there. I don't know, it's kind of just like, it looks cute. I mean, if you were into like the really bold dramatic eyeshadows, it could be a really pretty palette for like spring and next summer of 2019, but I know I don't need it, and it just, I don't know, it's kind of just not really like making me melt. ColourPop also, they have so much new makeup coming out. I can never keep up with them. Like, I've tried a lot of their products though, and I do really love them, but it's very, very overwhelming. Every time I go on their Instagram, I'm trying to find something, or even on their website, I'm like, oh my gosh, where do I even begin? Like, they have so much stuff. Like, it's a blessing and a curse, because obviously having a lot of variety is fun, and it's fun to be able to look through everything, but it's kind of just like, what do I get? What's good? What's not good? Like, I've tried a lot of their stuff, but not everything. All right, moving right along, we have some stuff from Makeup Geek. So it looks like you get here an eyeshadow palette, a mini lip gloss set, and then some lashes. So I'm not sure, actually, is this a full collection? I don't know if you can buy this all together. I think everything is like separate. The lashes are only $6 a piece, which is pretty good. The eyeshadow palette is $35 and the lip glazes are $15. And you also get a makeup blending sponge. So, kind of a fun fact, I've actually never tried anything from Makeup Geek. I don't know why, but Makeup Geek for me has always been one of those brands that never really drew me in. Like, the stuff looks good, but I just never made a purchase. I don't know why. It's just one of those brands that I'm not like drawn into, and I feel like a lot of this stuff, like for example the eyeshadow palette, it kind of reminds me of something like Profusion or like Milani eyeshadow palettes, like just stuff that's already out there and that's a lot more affordable. The lashes do look pretty, but I already have like my go-to favorite lashes in my collection, but I'm always very like picky with my lashes. So that is how I feel about Makeup Geek, but let me know what you guys think. I know that their stuff apparently is really, really good, so I would love to hear your thoughts. Let me know. Next up, I have some Juvia's Place. So this is the Heroin Glow 1 highlighters from Juvia's Place. I've actually tried Juvia's Place eyeshadows and face products. Their blushes are absolutely amazing. And the reason I'm including these in here is because, honestly, you guys, I have so many highlights in my collection that as crazy as it may seem, some of my favorite highlighters are actually from Makeup Revolution and Wet n Wild. Like, hands down, my absolute favorites. And they're affordable. So I feel like, for example, I have these two palettes right here from Makeup Revolution. These are their highlighter quads. And I feel like these two, honestly, are like the only highlighting palettes that I need in my life for like the rest of my life. Like, I know that's kind of dramatic, but seriously, like, freaking beautiful. I just feel like highlights are one of those things where it's like, what more can you really do with highlighting? Next, this isn't really a new product, but I guess it's like back in stock or whatever. I know it's been out of stock for a while. I actually wanted this when it first came out, but now come to look at it, I'm like, this is such a waste in my opinion. You guys know I love Fenty Beauty, but this is the Body Lava and it comes in two different sets. So they're $135 each. So I guess you get the Body Lava and then the Fairy Balm Glittering Pom Pom. You can literally put highlighter all over your body or get like a liquid highlighter. Like, I know Wet n Wild has one, L'Oreal has like a loose highlighter. Dump it in like some body spray and literally spray it all over your body. Add some moisturizer over top to make it like stick and you're good to go. Like, you don't need to spend that much money on Body Lava. I mean, it looks really beautiful, but I've actually heard some bad reviews about it for that price. I've heard that it's sticky and that it just gets everywhere. I personally don't like that. So, I was interested at first, but now I'm like, that's a lot of money. And last but not least, I have this Sigma Brush Cleaning Matte, as well as a Flat Top Kabuki. This is the gold or rose gold one, which looks really beautiful. I think honestly that the price on this is $35 because of the rose gold. Let me tell you guys. So first of all, I don't use the Flat Top Kabuki anymore. I have so many other favorite foundation brushes. I prefer something that's more like rounded or that's like this flat top brush. This is my favorite from Kokie. This is the 618 brush. Brushes like this that are more like just bigger, rounder, these are my favorite for foundation. Also, the brush cleaning mat. I have the pink one in my collection. It was sent to me in PR. I love it, but I actually have seen a really good dupe for it on Amazon. I've never used that one before just because I have this one. I think I'm just gonna purchase it just to see if it's actually a good dupe. But on the reviews, I've heard that it is an exact dupe for the Sigma one and it's like a quarter of the price. So I will link it down below, but I just feel like stuff like that, you don't need to spend a lot of money on things like that because there's always dupes on Amazon. Amazon is like my go-to place to find like makeup brushes or just like random things that maybe you can't find at Target or Walmart or Ulta, but you can find them there and they're like so affordable. You can also find these things like this at like Marshall's or TJ Maxx. They're super affordable and they're great. They make cleaning your brushes like 10 times easier, so check it out. All right guys, so that is it for this anti-haul. Let me know what you guys think. What are you not interested in buying or what are you interested in buying? And what do you think about the products that I mentioned? Once again, please do not be offended. You guys know I love these brands and I love you guys and I understand that we all have different opinions when it comes to makeup, so I hope you guys understand as well because it's nothing personal, it's just makeup. So I hope you guys enjoy the video for what it is worth. Thank you so much for everything. I hope you're doing well. I love you guys and I'll see you in a few days in my next one. Bye.